So, hello, nice to see you again. I have not posted for a while because, well, as I promise, if I have nothing to tell or share, then I won't post. Again, low quality. I don't want to take care of the audio and the video too much. I just want to show some stuff what I'm doing. So today I got in a few parts, mainly around batteries and small cages. And when I posted it on Facebook, I already got a few questions. So I think it's time to show the video. The first question what I got was basically about what kind of a battery pack I was using. Now, if you watch the old video videos, I was using these blocks, which are called X-Pro. And the nice thing about them is that you can use this high voltage connector to directly use the D-Tap connector in your Sony cameras. There's two problems with this one. A is quite big, so this is a really big one, like 15,000 or 16,000 milliamps, so it's quite heavy. My memory is about 350 grams. And the second problem is, they have a smaller one, by the way. The second problem is that it was really hard to get for especially people in outside of Europe and even in Europe. And in America, you could not get it at all. So the nice thing is, or the bad thing is, these kind of disappeared. At least I can't find them that easily anymore. But there's a Dutch brand called Jupio. I'm now showing you it. Which, in my opinion, either brought the rights or maybe the supplier. Because if you look at the connections, you can see that they are clearly the same. And it seems that they now are on the market from this brand. Now, the one that I got is a much smaller one. It's about, I think it's 5600 milliamps. So about five times the normal size of a battery. Five to six times the size. So, and what I did, you can see that I already kind of modded it a little bit. And that was what people were asking me questions about, is I added a cold shoe connector so that you can sort of hook it up to different parts of your small rig. So let me show it on the 6500 small rig cage and hook it in. And you can see, I did it the wrong way around, but now it's on the floor. Well, hopefully it survived. So let me hook it in. So there it is. You can see that it sort of nicely attaches to the side. You can do it on the top or the side or wherever. And you can feed the camera, and I'm also feeding a small LCD display with it. And people were sort of asking, hey, what are you doing and how are you doing it? It should be, in my case, it's able with this size to feed the camera for about 3 hours, including the LCD, which is on top there. So let me get it off again. So that's basically what people are asking about. A, what kind of battery is this? And B, how can you attach it to the camera or to a cage? Of course, you can also attach it to a camera now this way. And it really is quite easy. I sort of took it from one of these easy plastic sort of connectors that you can put your cold shoe on. If you people really ask me, I can probably tell you the brand of which one I took apart. And I glued it on. Seems to be fine. Except that I also put some glue here, which was not my idea. And of course, but in general, the idea is that you can hook it up like this. You can still use it in its normal form, right? In or I made especially small wires myself so that I don't have this whole big thing, so that it's a little bit smaller to be able when you got it on the rig. Now it comes with, of course, this part. It comes with a battery itself, and it comes with a cage. And you can see this is the big one. Because it's still totally complete. This one I already had to hack up a little bit. You can see I made took a slice out there so that I can still sort of put it in its original case, but now, of course, with some room for this attachment. So you can still put it in the bag like this if you want to, or you can even still hook it up in its original form. I think this one was about 50 euros. So I even then, I don't think that's a bad deal. This one was, in fact, I remember a little bit cheaper, especially the same size. But that's what it is. The nice thing is that it's now shipping worldwide, and they actually have a lot of other interesting parts. So this is the first video, and I will move on to a few others. So if you want to see how this is combined with a new cage, you can also watch the other ones. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.